তার মানে ইউটিউবে গিয়ে দেখো তো হচ্ছে কিনা,
আচ্ছা
আগে আগে যে আমাদের কলেজে যেটা আছে না সেটা দেখো পরে।
ঠিক আছে, দেখছি দেখছি। না এখনো কিছু কিন্তু লাইভ শেয়ার হয়নি।
এখনো ইয়ে হচ্ছে, এবার দেখো, এবার দেখাবে।
হ্যাঁ এবার এসছে, হ্যাঁ
ঠিকঠাক
এবার
আছে তো?
এসছে। হম এসছে।
লিঙ্কটা শেয়ার করে দিবি নাকি?
হ্যাঁ লিঙ্কটা শেয়ার
না
করে দে।
হয়েছে, ভিডিও তো আছে, ভিডিও ভিডিও দেখাচ্ছে তো, দেখাচ্ছে ভিডিও।
ঠিক আছে, হয়ে গেছে কানেক্ট।
ওই লিঙ্কটা তাহলে শেয়ার করে দিস।
আর লিঙ্কটা যদি কেউ চাই, যারা আসানসোল কাজ করে সাবস্ক্রাইব করিস না, পেয়ে যাবে আর কি।
লিঙ্কটা একটু দাদা কপি করে একটু চ্যাট বক্সে দিয়ে দাও না, আমি এটা কপি করে কপি করে আমাদের হোয়াটসঅ্যাপ গ্রুপ যে দুটো বানিয়েছি ওটা দিয়ে দিই।
আমি জুমের চ্যাট বক্সে দিচ্ছি, কারণ আমি তো এখন ল্যাপটপ আছি তো, মোবাইল নেই তো।
তো এখানে
তোমার মেল করে দেবো কি?
দাদা একটু, না না আমি আমার যে হোয়াটসঅ্যাপ দুটো গ্রুপ বানিয়ে,
হ্যাঁ হোয়াটসঅ্যাপ গ্রুপে আমি এখন করতে পারছি না, এখান থেকে আমার ল্যাপটপ থেকে নিচ্ছি। তা হোয়াটসঅ্যাপ গ্রুপে ল্যাপটপ থেকে করবো কি করে? ইউটিউবটা মোবাইলে খুলো না, সব তো ভালো তো দেখছি। তন্ময়,
হ্যাঁ
তুমি ইউটিউবটা তো মোবাইল দিয়ে খুলে ওখান থেকে,
ওখান থেকে লিঙ্কটা নিয়ে নেবো।
হ্যাঁ আমি এতে আছি তো, এই নাম ল্যাপটপ আছি তো, আমি তোমার মেইলে দিতে পারি, কিন্তু আমি এতে দেবো।
তুমি তাহলে মেলেই দাও না, আমি জাস্ট খালি মেলটাকে লিঙ্কটাকে কপি করবো।
হ্যাঁ তাই করে। কি নাম তোমার মেলটার? কি ছিল জানো?
TNMAY,
হ্যাঁ তন্ময়, আচ্ছা MAY,
আচ্ছা MO না MA,
হ্যাঁ TNMAY,
হ্যাঁ GRP
জি
RP
পি, হ্যাঁ
1989
1989
@gmail.com।
আর 7 মিনিট বাকি দেখাচ্ছে,
হ্যাঁ
এবার তো ঢোকাতে হবে, 140 জন আছে পার্টিসিপেন্ট।
হ্যাঁ ঢুকি ঢুকি, ওই তন্ময় পাঠালাম, লিখে শেয়ার করে দাও। পেলো দেখো মেলটা?
হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ আমি দেখছি, আমি একবার আমাদের স্পিকারকে একবার কনফার্ম করে দিই, ঢুকে যেতে বলি,
হ্যাঁ
দেখি
আমি
লোড দেখি
অ্যাডমিট
ঢুকেছে
করে
কিনা,
দিচ্ছি।
তারপরে
লাইভ অন ইউটিউব চলে আসছে।
হ্যাঁ কপি ইউআরএল,
Carmine?
मैडम
তুমি কি কিছু বলবে
না
বলবে না তাহলে একটা মিউট
सब अपना स्पीकर बंद कर लीजिए प्लीज सब अपना
प्रदीप दा प्रदीप दा
हेलो
हां बोलची मैडम एचपी बोले আছে পার্টিসিপেট एचपी কোহোস্ট করে দাও হ্যাঁ एचपी
एचपी ओनली एचपी
ओनली एचपी
अच्छा देखें
घटक सर इस सिन
ऑनली एचपी तो कुछ पाचना है को
ऑनली एचपी धोखे नहीं ना
एचपी आचे ओनली एचपी आचे एचपी
आचे ना धोखे जान क्यों देख लाखों तो कुछ पाचना है सर्च को लेके
ओ अच्छा लाखों चला का चला बोले एचपी चिलेक तो आगे
हाँ एक तो जान क्यों चला
एचपी जस्ट आगे चिलेक तो आगे
HP চোখে পড়ছে
না HP নেই ও চেঞ্জ করে যাও ফোন করে দেখো
আরেকবার ফোন করছে
এখন HP নেই
আরেকবার জয়েন করতে বলো
स्कूल
Yes, sir. Any... Sanjay, can you get
Yes, Shaji.
Please start. No. Okay.
বললাম নাম চেঞ্জ করে ঢুকছে, এইচপির নামে নেই, নাম চেঞ্জ করে ঢুকছে।
Hello and very good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to everyone joining in this forum to discuss from various parts of the world. I do hope and wish
for the Dr. Swati Sinha. Dr. Swati Sinha.
বলতে পারি
হ্যালো প্রদীপ দা প্লিজ মিউট অল হ্যালো প্রদীপ দা মিউট করে দাও সবাইকে
তোমার মিউট করে নেবে তুমি গান মিউট করে নাও
হ্যাঁ Am I visible or am I audible?
Yeah.
So let's start right now, no?
Yeah.
A very good morning to all respected delegates and participants. Myself, Tanmoy Shah, librarian on behalf of Asansol Girls College, welcome you all in this webinar session. Here, we have participants not only from India, but also from abroad. Hope all of we are safe and staying in home. Asansol Girls College believes that staying home does not stop from doing work. Every day we do different types of creation, creative work, and innovation. But most of us, honor of participating, but most of us, honor of protecting our ideas, creativity, and our invention. Even UGC has recognized the value of IPR. That's why UGC included IPR as a general elective subject in PCS system. On the other hand, NIRF is also giving much more importance for their ranking system. Now, I would like to request our honorable vice principal sir to officially inaugurate this webinar session and say few words for today's webinar. Sir, please come on the webinar platform and say few words.
Thank you, Tanmoy. May I audible to all of you? May I audible to all of you? Yes, sir. May I audible to all of you?
Yes, sir, audible.
Yes.
Yeah.
You are audible.
Okay, thank you. Thank you to all of you. Very good morning to all of you. And in this probably third national webinar, I welcome on behalf of the team of Asansol Girls College all the respected delegates, participants, and my colleagues. The topic chosen by the Learning Science Department is very relevant if we consider it in the context of the present scenario. Other day we have also discussed about the intellectual property rights, but that was from a different point of view. But now we discuss about our topic is intellectual property rights, concepts and needs. This part is very important because first of all, we have to make clarity our ideas about the intellectual property rights, what it is and what are its different aspects, what is different frontiers. And after that, we have to find out the way by which we can take the advantage of these rights, that is intellectual property rights. And for that, I think we have a very good and renowned resource persons with us. Due to time constraint, I'll not linger my speech, and hereby I like to inaugurate the national webinar. Today's national webinar on intellectual property rights, their concepts and needs. So again, I am giving thanks to all of you who participate in this seminar, and also thanks the organizing committee of the Asansol Girls College for holding such a very relevant topics. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir, for your hello. Thank you, sir, for your valuable speech.
Thank you.
And enlightened us. Now, I will introduce our respected speaker, Dr. Swati Sinha, associate professor and former head of law department, Kazi Nazrul University. She is a former assistant professor of Medinipur Law College, Haldia Law College, and the former assistant professor of University of North Bengal. She has lot of research experience in legal education in India, banking of law, ecofeminism, and socio-legal research. Now, I would like to request our honorable speaker to deliver her speech. Our technical team, please allow Dr. Swati Sinha to share her screen. Hello. Hi, ma'am.
Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Namaskar. Very good morning. Now, respected principal here in Chairman IQSC, Dr. Sandeep Khattak. The coordinators IQSC, Professor Somerset, I am in high spirit to congratulate other coordinators IQSC, Sri Kupal Kunar, Sri Nandlal Mandal. My regards are with all the members of the organizing committee, Professor Surajit Jana, Professor Hiru Rajan,
Madam, unmute yourself. Swati Madam, please unmute yourself.
I have already unmuted.
Yeah, okay, fine.
Okay. Last, of course, I will be failed in my duty if I will not say a few words for Tanmay Saha, Sri Tanmay Saha. During this pandemic situation, we generally say that it is easy to organize webinars. Generally, when we organize seminars, then we invest our physical efforts and financial efforts much more. But during this webinar session, whoever is organizing this kind of webinars, then we invest our mental effort, a lot of stress. But as a faculty members, as the members of academia, all the teachers, we are trying to upgrade ourselves through these webinars. Sometimes we are organizing it and sometimes we are participating in it. So very good morning to Tanmay Saha, who was trying from the last few months to organize this webinar. His efforts are endless in this regard. All the members on the screen and off the screen. Today, I'm here to share a little knowledge of myself about intellectual property rights. So now, with this little knowledge as a student of law, I'm going to share my screen where I will say few lines about the intellectual property rights. Hello. My slide, sir. I'm sharing my slide. Is it okay? Hello? Hello?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Continue. Okay.
Intellectual property rights, today's topic, concept and need. As we are here to discuss intellectual property rights for the educational institution, so giving preference to my student, I will start with this symbol, myself, as introduced by Tanmay Saha, Dr. Swati Sinha, Associate Professor, Department of Law, Kazi Nazrul University. I will start. I have arrested these following space here. Concept, then need, then when to be granted, basically, how we will get it, how to file an application, procedure of filing application, how to write our own patent application, the procedure at of date in the patent office, then for what period we are entitled to get this right, what are the rights we get, and if anybody is infringing our right, then what would be the remedy, and of course, last but not least, as suggested by UGC, that we will search that whether by study of this particular subject course we will get any employment or not. Let's start. I told you that we have started from a symbol of rupee. So, symbol of rupee. This is the best example of intellectual. When we will define the word intellectual property and right, these three terms separately, then we will start from intellectual. Intellectual word, it is not easy to define it. Because this is something intangible. Intangible in the sense we can't see it. We can't, you can say we can't feel it. Like any other tangible property. Land, we can see it. All the other tangible property, we can observe, we can get the existence. But for intellectual, what we are thinking right now, what the others are thinking, what's going on in our mind, it's quite difficult for us to understand. And that intellectuality example I can give by the symbol or mark of that rupee, which is now very much used for us Indian countries. This is the intellectual property created by one of the students. I will start from the student. It is basically a particular symbol.
Madam, unmute. Please unmute yourself, ma'am.
Ma'am, please unmute your speaker.
Ma'am, please unmute.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes, yes, yes.
Please unmute and continue.
Yes, yes, yes. Now, so this is the best example of intellectuality to explain the intellectuality. This is the symbol. It was created by one student named D. Uday Kumar. He was a visual, he was a student of visual design from the Industrial Design Center of IIT Bombay. When we give a look on this, it's just simply looking very rough. It's in Devanagari script. But what created, what the sense of intellectuality he has used here, and he has explained this in application of the, you can take copyright. He said that this is Ra, means Devanagari Lipi, and for the global world. He has adopted the language Latin script R, where only the capillaries bar was absent for R. Now, when we just go to the upper part of the symbol, we find two parallel lines in three-dimensional form, which gives actually an illusion of tricolor of the flag. This he wrote in his application. It gives an illusion of the tricolor of flag, which is the national flag for we Indian. In between these two parallel lines in three-dimensional form, we get a small white line, which is the third line used here in three-dimensional form. And he said that this shows the simplicity of our country. This shows equity or equality, that is the concept of universal brotherhood. And we basically start our constitution from this equality by using the word we, the people of India. And we have promised in our constitution of India that we are equal, irrespective of the reasonable classification. So this is the example of intellectual. He was a student, but he actually has given us a new thought about the creativity. This is intellectual. Property, as we know, there are two types of property, tangible, intangible. We have heard a lot about it. So intellectual property is basically intangible property. Now, right means a claim. When we claim over something, that I will use it, it is a kind of privilege given to us. So here, intellectual property right, we can divide under this course or under this topic in two parts. These are very known to all of us. Very simple thing, that intellectual property right is granted for industrial property and for copyright, a creative work. So under industrial property, we have a different kinds of property here, patent, right, trademarks, trade secrets, industrial design, geographical indications, layout of designs of integrated circuit, which is basically given for semiconductors and all these, and the plant varieties. We know that India is basically a agro-based country. So here, that plant variety is the new inclusion in this series. Patent, by the term, it is very clear that it is granted for invention. Trademark is for a mark. Trade secret means the systematic approach of carrying on any business or trade. Industrial design, it is a design applied on any article. Geographical indication, this is the indication when an object actually dignified a particular location. Geographical indication. In layout design, we basically protect the topography or the design of that semiconductors and the conductors used in planning all the machineries or the tools part of there. And the plant variety, due to the technological development of the microbiology and the genetic research, etc., in the plant sector, in the agriculture sector, basically this plant variety concept came in India. And of course, copyright, that is very vital part of any educational institution. I have here, you just see, I have written here, original expressed works of authorship. So here, original in the sense that it should be expressed in original word. I'm putting stress on express word. It is not granted for an idea. In what sense I say, if I'm thinking about a particular drama or a painting or drawing or the literary works or composition of any music, I am thinking in my mind and I am discussing it with my friend, and the movement, I'm discussing my idea with my friend, and if he has published all these things in any of the way of communication, then that friend will be the copyright creator. Rather, my idea will not get any protection over there. The copyright is for the person who is expressing it. I may be an author, but I can never be an owner for copyright in this situation. The copyright is original express work of authorship. Your authorship includes two kinds of authorship. One who is creating, he is an author, and another who is expressing it is the owner. So copyright is granted to owner. Yes, in different cases, author becomes owner. So if somebody is saying that I am the owner of copyright, that means if person has expressed the thing, original thing, and he will only entitled to get this right. So copyright is granted for expression, not for an idea. Then why we are in need of this intellectual, why we are here discussing, what was the need of inclusion of this kind of property under the Indian scenario. The justifications in the different cases, we have got that it is essential for our country for basically these four reasons. That we are investing our time, it matters. We are investing a huge amount of capital. Bring it on surface, it matters. The free flow of energy. The free flow of energy means we are giving a lot of efforts to bring it on this. It matters. And of course, when we are investing something, then for whom I am investing? Who is there? Who will see that I have invested money, I have invested time? Of course, the public. So keeping in mind public interest, if I am doing all these things, then I am only entitled to get right to use it. And I will be fearless if I get some kind of protection from the state so that public will get some utility or will exploit it with my permission and will give something, will contribute something in the nation's development. Now when we talk about this need, we should start from the history. Without going through any historical development, we generally, and lots of the countries from the world, basically, they are feeling very proud that intellectuality or intellectual property right came in existence due to the introduction of World Trade Organization. And World Trade Organization, through the various expressed contract, conventions, treaty, has brought this intellectual property. But I want to share my few words where we will see that the documents are available with us beside this mythological part of Vishwamitra and Vasishtha. We will rely on the document. And we have the documents, ancient documents, where we have got the concept of intellectual property right. So myth is that there was no intellectual property right in our country. We have adopted it through these conventions and treaties. But the reality is, yes, it was in existence. Yes, we were. Whole thing of property that was based on morality. I have written here in my PPT, you will find out that there are three phases of development in Vedic era, and through those phases we can assess that intellectual property right was existing. If I am just giving a note here that Yograj Basu is an author of Vedic Parichay, and he has quoted the various verses of the Arthashastra, Dharma Shastra, Smriti,
there we find that the first stage was, just you see here, the first stage was Vedic recitation style. So intellectual property right was there, but we were not looking towards the state, that state will give protection to us. Morally, we were so high that we, by our individualistic approach, we were not interfering or trying to copy the work of others. And if even we were able to do this anyhow, then anybody, any ordinary man or the man with ordinary prudence will identify my copying, identify my wrong activity. He said that there were 11 methods of Vedic recitation style, like garland text was there, skill text was there. So through this way, he has given context text was there. So these were the 11 method of recitation. And beside this 11 method, if any person is chanting the Vedic mantras without following these methods, then will be identified very easily. This was the systematic intellectuality approach in Veda. Then the second phase, when we have got our epics and Puranic text, the intellectual property, we have tried to accommodate, adapted all the changes which were coming with the changing society. If we take one text from there in the second phase, Mahabharata. The Mahabharata itself came in the third page in the three different means ages through the particular Jana Bharat and then Mahabharat. So Gyan, Bharat and Mahabharat. This was the third phase. This was the second phase where solely we were responsible for our own selves and we were not trying even to detect the other things. So the people were easily, they were free, they were using their intellectuality in the society freely. There was no fear to copy it. Then the third phase came where the role of state came in existence. This was the phase of Arthashastra and Dharmashastra. Here we find that state was giving protection to two kind of property. One was Vastu property, which today we call tangible property. And another was Yoga Shema. That is, yoga pointed out to the recognition of a particular, you can say, an object. And people have started now to commercialize this object through their yoga shema. That if I have identified an object, then in future I will get some kind of benefits from this object. So yoga shema was protected. Later on, the vidya dhana. Vidya was the knowledge. So knowledge-based economy. From there, in Arthashastra, we can find out that the concept of intellectual property came in existence. In the Smriti Chandrika, we find that by the particular Narada Smriti, there approximately 7,000 to 8,000 Kavyas were challenged on the ground of taking intellectual properties of the saints and the people who were creating it under this Yoga Shema. So, and this was the third AD, this was the period from where we have started creating the Kavyas. So, dear friends, we will not always say that we have got this from some other country. Yes, the in codified form or in the form of standard form of contract, if I use the commercial language, standard form of contract, these things came with the help of World Trade Organization, WIPO, TRIPS, GIMS, etc. Now, the third one is that whether whatever we are thinking, whatever we are creating, whatever the research are, whether we will get it in the form of intellectual property, whether we are entitled to get it. So in all different types, like patent, trademark, trade secrets, everywhere, we have got that few words are interchangeably used. What kind of words? We sometimes use new, sometimes use novel, original, non-obvious. So there is a distinction in these words. For patent, we use new and novel. For copyright, we use original word. The main aim to use interchangeably these words is that it should be the first-hand preparation or research work. For patent, it is, and for the trademark also, that it is written that with this newness of creation, with the newness of the invention, it should be non-obvious to us. In the patent law, we say that patent is granted for invention. So here we can understand the meaning of invention. Non-obvious means nowhere in the world or nowhere in our own country this particular method or system or the product has been used by any people. No prior use was done. Here we can differentiate invention and discovery. For invention, we get patent, not for the discovery. For example, in discovery, one person can discover a thing that is also new. But that is not novel and original. Community, maybe from the tribal community, maybe from the Ayurveda sector, someone was able to use this particular new thing. So I can discover, but when I am using this discovery and creating a medicine from that discovery, then for that invention, I'm entitled to get. Now, beside this new, novel, original, and non-obviousness, that means the first-hand creation, even we are not entitled to get intellectual property. Then the third very essential criteria is because our country, the whole world is based nowadays on knowledge-based economy. So whether my knowledge is capable of commercial exploitation, whether my knowledge for which I actually claim protection, whether that knowledge which contribute economically in our country, that is called commercial exploitation. So these three things together gave us a claim for intellectual property right. Now, how to get it? Intellectual property, how we will get it? Sometimes we get it the moment we have created it, like the copyright, trademarks, design also. So without registration, we can claim few intellectual property rights. But there, the remedy we will get only through the administrative process. Judiciary, we can't claim. Because after registration, a register is maintained for my creation. It would be easier for me to claim that these were my things and I have claimed for this. But in absence of the registration, we are not able to move there. Then through registration, we can get this right. Where to register? We have a website. I have written here. You just see ipindia.gov.in. There we will get all the information. So very small part I have taken from there, that where to file application and procedure of filing application. If I go to the next slide, you will find out that where to file application. The Patent, Design and Trademark, office of the controller is situated at Mumbai. Now, from there for patent, head office is in Kolkata and the branch offices are in Chennai, New Delhi and Mumbai. So, everywhere we can file these offices. The trademark registry is at Mumbai. Its branches are in Kolkata, Chennai, Ahmedabad and New Delhi. Design office is solely in Kolkata, in the patent office of Kolkata. So it is the jurisdiction of filing application is in Kolkata only for design. Geographical indication registry has been established in Chennai. Administer the geographical indications of the goods. So these are the few information. I know that you all know about it, but very little I have shared. Without this, I can't go to the next slide. That's why. Now, how to file? This is very important part. Basically, we are living in a country where ignorancia of law is not an excuse, but unfortunately, a student from nursery, he understands every subcourses. Geography, history, social study, general knowledge, all the views burden on that child for whom ignorancia of law is not an excuse, never study law in legal form. Just in moral value, we can give some kind of morality which were enshrined under the constitution. But the moment a question, any dispute will arise, we start finding advocates. But for this claiming intellectual property right, there is no need first to move there. Yes, the role of advocate is there. We will discuss later on. But we can file by our own effort. Even any student can file application here. There are two types of. One is in physical form, physical filing of the application in patent office. And the second one is electronic filing. That was started in the year 2007 in 20th July. Now, how to file? I will first start from e-filing. That is that we can start from our own. From our own PC, from our own mobile. We will first visit that particular website and there we will get a e-filing portal, e-gateway. From there, we will stepwise, we will go if I am a user and I have already registered my name, then I will log in by using my user ID. But user ID, password or digital signature. And once logged in, the user can file their application using the quick form filling option. I'm just giving a, you can say the image of that particular e-filing gateway. Yes, you see this particular image, you will find out that the little arrow here, it indicates e-gateway. So just see here, this is the e-gateway. Through this portal, we will enter into that particular site. And here in below, you will find out there are few words written, which are, since this is an image, so we cannot identify what is written here. In the next slide, I have written these four, 1, 2, 3, 4 part in this slide. E-filing, payment of the fee, then WIPO, EPCT, e-filing, trademarks, everything we will get in e-gateway. The moment we will enter into the comprehensive filing, first icon in e-gateway, we will get all these informations. Now, if I want to file patent, I will move here. Just see this one, e-filing patent. I want to pay fee for that. This is the next. Then WIPO EPCT, that means for international application and searches, I will go here. For filing trademarks, this. So step by, we will reach here and whatever we want to file and in form of application for my intellectual property, I'll move on this particular icon. Now, say for example, e-filing patent. The moment we will open this icon, we will get this kind of image over there. This will appear on our screen. And here, beside all other information, we will log in with this. I have my password, sometime username, then ID, and will give some task to us. I have to finish that task, and thereafter we will take entry. Then through this gateway, we will payment, we will pay the payment, etc. And then we will easily enter into the registration office. Now, if I am filing manually in the patent office, then with form number 23, first we have to file that form. And with this, we have to attach a separate sheet. The sheet which is attached over there, we have to write in on the first front page the abstract of my work. Sometimes my work is very descriptive, so I will write abstract of description. Then what my invention is. Invention is about what? Whether I want to claim process patent, product patent, or both of them. Then we will move to the invention, commercial utilization of my invention. What is the use for the society? Then I go to the main part where I write my description. But one thing I have to keep in mind, that in that description part, we will neither claim any kind of right, or we will not share any kind of drawing or confidential matter on that application. Otherwise, there would be a probability to use this. So prior art, we will not use here. So with this form 23, I have to write my own patent in this form. Then, what is, when I have filed my application either manually or e-filing, then what is the procedure adopted by the patent office? In patent office, for examination and all other things, my application is in queue. For publication of my application, patent office takes 18 months. After 18 months, it is published and oppositions are invited. That if any person, by person or through any society or through any organization, wants to create objection, then he will get right over there. So he can create. Now that person will request for examination. Who has opposed my invention, he will request for the examination. Now examination may be granted or may be refused. If refused, then the officer, the registrar, has to give notice of this in written form, and this is a part of principle of natural justice. That reasoned decision, I have to record the reason why I am refusing to examine the invention. If the examination is granted, then it will be examined again later on, it will be published. And then if the objection does not sustain after the examination, then that patent is granted and it is published. Again, there is a provision, there is a time limit where post-grant opposition is invited. That after grant of this patent, anybody has invented or has then for that post-grant opposition is invited. And if again, it may be granted, it may be refused. If granted, then controller put his signature over that particular document and we get our right. Now, when we get our right, what, for which period? you know, in a Vedic period, through this 11 method, we were able to keep the originality of the Vedic text and Vedic literature for thousands of years. But here, maximum period is 60 years. And for each rite, the time limit is in this way. I'm giving few examples. For patent, it is 20 years from the date of application. For copyright, it is lifetime of the owner plus 60 years. But there are few exceptions, like if the copyright is created through any corporation, it is for the government institution, anonymous works, pseudonymous work, posthumous works are there, then it is only granted for 60 years. Trademark is 10 years, but it can be renewed. Design is first for the 10 years, and rest next for 5 years, it can be renewed. Then layout design, it is also for the 10 years protection. Plant varieties, here the duration has not been fixed. This duration of protection of the registered variety of plant is different for different crops. I have given here only two examples, like for the trees and vines, it is 18 years. And for the crops and the other extant variety, it is for 15 years. Then, what are the rights for this 20 years, 60 years, 15 years? What are the different rights we get? From all the different types of intellectual property, industrial property and copyright, I have chosen these words. We get exclusive right. That means this is right only granted to me. Under copyright, I can use my copyright for authorizing others to copy it. So copyright we get. We can sell it. We can transfer it. We can grant license to other persons to use it in public. We can transmit it from one place to another place or through the inheritance. We can sell it. There is a difference between that first sale and the last. In first sale, S-A-L-E, it means the contract to sell or agreement to sell. But when there is a contract of sale, by taking consideration, then we use in law S-E-L-L. So we can sell, we can sell, and of course, last but not least even, we can relinquish or waive this intellectual property, right? Which I have got from an authority. Now in our law, there is a maxim, Latin proverb, we say, that you be jus, I be remedium. I be remedium, that means, where there is a right, there is a remedy. Now, if all these rights will be infringed by any person, any authority, any institution, this natural person and the legal person, then where will we go? And this was the reason for the registering our intellectual property. Then we have two kind of remedies here. First remedy is administrative remedy. With the help of this registrar office, we can get protection of our right in the first page. Then the matter is relating to the registration, matter is relating to the exclusive right in some specific fields. Someone has copied, someone is not accepting my registration. There is a case of passing off action, etc., etc. Then we can take help from administration. And here, I have just written in this form, then a person who wants remedy from this administration, he will start from this lower side. He will move first to the joint controller of patent. And he is the ultimate authority who is protecting our intellectuality. If we move from the upward direction, then there are two ministry who are protecting or who have managed the state responsibility. Minister of Commerce and Industry for Industrial Property, he has delegated his power to the Department of Industrial Policy and Promotion. He has again sub-delegated to the Controller General of the Patent Design and Trademark. Later on, through this controller office, we have got that how many offices are there. They are managing the whole affairs of the intellectual properties in our all parts of the countries. And the second one is the Ministry of Human Resource Development for second type of property, which we call copyright. Here it is delegated to the Department of Education. Department of Education has given this particular, delegated this duty to the Copyright Office, and Copyright Office has created one, has established one registrar of the copyright, which is situated in Delhi. Judicial remedy, we can get both type of remedy over here, civil remedy as well as the criminal remedy. Civil remedy in the form of injunction. If somebody is inventing my property, then like any other tangible property, the court can grant injunction, temporary or permanent in nature, then the sealing of the goods, seizure, fine, etc. And in criminal remedy, even the provision is there where one can be imprisonment. One can be imprisoned in the jail. And one can ask this question that where we will go first time when we want any judicial remedy. Then of course, we will move to the court which should not be below the rank of the district court. And we as a member of academia in Asansol, we are very fortunate that in Asansol, we have got one district court. And from there, we will follow the court procedure. High court is there. Somebody, if they have got the high court in their jurisdiction for infringement, then can file case in high court also. And from there, the normal, then in this place, basically, we are in need of an advocate. Here, in this phase, we will enjoy our right with the help of the law. Then I said that UGC is putting emphasis on two different structure of curriculum. One, that we will first fix our vision object for every course through this choice-based credit system. We are the people. Here we have taken this, you can say that this challenge to accept choice-based credit system within this West Bengal and our university, we will say, we can say we all are proud that we have taken this challenge, which was put forwarded to us by UGC in 2014 and has said that you design your curricula with an object. With each course, we have an object. And we will also expect from our student that we will get this kind of things from the student. We want, and we have given something in return, we will get this kind of knowledge from our student. Then this is called learning outcome. And the last one is that if I have given knowledge to my student, and if my students are not getting job, then the third is that in every course, we have to convince them that if you will carry forward your study in this manner, then you will get employment in this intellectual property, right? With this vision, I am sharing the employability, because here a huge number of students are also there. Our friends are, we are very fortunate that we have got the employment, but few friends of mine who are of similar qualifications and everything, they are possessing, but they are not able to exploit their knowledge economically. For them also, with this subject, what we can contribute in the society to this economy, we can say that the first kind of job which we can create by study of this intellectual property is patent examiner. Here the qualification in all these patent examiner, patent agent and scientific advisor, you will say the minimum age is 21 years. He must be a citizen of India. This is the basic requirement. Then with this, in all these cases, you will find out that must has obtained the bachelor degree in engineering or science with 4 years courses at an accredited, means beside this bachelor degree, if I am claiming examiner for a particular stream of science, then 4 years course at an accredited college or university leading to bachelor's degree. Or the higher that included a major field of study or specific course requirement in variety of engineering and science disciplines. So graduation right now in country, we have started graduating the student within 3 years, sometime within 4 years, and sometime with integrated manner with the MSc and MA also. So this is the first thing where the student can apply. And almost every after 6 months, we get the advertisement from the registrar office of patent for patent examination. The second is patent agent. And here, with all these graduation course and all this, the student must be an advocate. Advocate means practicing advocate. Generally, who passed the LLB, he or she is a lawyer. But after registration with the Bar Council of India, he becomes advocate in practice. So this science graduate or the any kind of graduate with LLB and at least 10 years experience as patent examiner. So if any student becomes patent examiner, then within this 10 years, he can acquire the knowledge of LLB or he can pass this LLB and automatically he will be promoted in patent agent. But if anybody has this qualification and experience of 10 years, then directly he can also file an application for patent agent. Then the third one is for this first patent examiner and patent examiner and agent, generally they issue advertisement. But for this scientific advisor, registrar office makes or impanels in name of few knowledgeable person whom he will recruit as scientific advisor. And this is for us, the person having qualification like us. He should hold a degree in science. This is the basic thing. At least 15 years experience, practical experience in any research institute and hold the responsibility as a post of scientist, scientific or technological department of the central or state government or in any organization. He can file forced application in the registrar's office and he may be recruited as scientific advisor. When impaneled for scientific advisor, he can continue up to 3 years. And after 3 years, he's on the basis of his capability, on the basis of his experience in the work, on the basis of the outcome, productive outcome, his term can be renewed. So this was the last topic. Now with this, I'm giving again a big thanks to all the members who are on the screen and behind the screen, off screen, who have kept patience to just listen me. Thank you very much. Now I invite, of course, from the chat box, few questions.
Hello.
Hello, fellow.
Thank you, ma'am, for your nice presentation. Now our question and answer session will start. Participants are requested to put your question in chat box, and the question answer session will be handled by Professor Nilam Sabina Murmu. Welcome. Nilam, please take over your session. Hello. Hello, Nilam. Am I audible?
Yes, audible. Am I audible?
Hello. Please take over your session.
That a question you will say, or I will take it from the screen.
Ma'am, I have taken some questions.
Okay.
Please, from the chat box.
Yes, please.
First question is, what do you mean by industrial design?
Okay, very good question. Industrial design is a kind of creation on an article, and that article must be produced industrially in the sense that in manual form or by applying some kind of power means electronic power or any kind of other chemical things. When it is this particular power is applied on an article, and that article, that creation on that article gives an aesthetic look for industrial application, then we can claim industrial design under Industrial Design Act 2000. Okay? So it should be the creation on an article. Article must be produced industrially, manually, or in any other process. And of course, it must have some economic value, because without commercial exploitation, we can't claim anything under the intellectual property. So that must be commercially exploited, and it is identified only by the aesthetic look. We don't want to explain here new and non-obvious. If the person is ready to explain that this is aesthetic, then one can. And the right here is granted is called copyright. Yes.
Okay, ma'am. Our next question is from Priyanka Ghosh. Her question is, in case of interest of public at large, can the patent granting process be made within the short span of time? For example, in this pandemic situation, the various medicinal trials is going throughout the different parts of the world. Can any country claim for the speedy approval of the grant of patent for any such medicine?
Yes. Of course, for this kind of situation, whatever the applications are pending in the patent office, because this pandemic situation, government plays an important role. So their patent will be granted, but not in the name of that person. Because for that person, it is compulsory to go through the whole process. Because this is a process. Your time is only for examination and all this. So if government wants to give patent, then government will take it responsibility, and the patent will be granted in the name of government. And there, government will be solely responsible for managing the commercial exploitation of this particular patent.
Okay, ma'am. Next question is from M. Kafun Singh. His question is, what are the positive and negative impact of patenting of tribal salt, as recent trend in fashion industry shows various misuse, plagiarism? For example, men salt uses female skirt, also discriminating the tribal community in regard to the ownership. So what is your view in this regard?
Question is not clear actually to me. Whether this question is relating to plagiarism, or it is relating to the traditional knowledge?
This question is, I think, related to the plagiarism, that is men's cells in case of fashion industry. They are using the men's cell as the, women's cell as a skirt in case of men.
Okay, that means copyright is here created, or plagiarized word is something different. Huh? This is not actually the thing. Plagiarized word we use in other sense. Traditional, it will, the question will come under the exploitation of traditional knowledge. I told you that there is a process of, traditional knowledge. There is a process of copying the traditional knowledge or exploiting the traditional knowledge through Copyright Act. And there is a bank created by WIPO where the knowledge, the person who is holding that knowledge, he will come and he will give informations to the authorities under this authority of this one. And if that authority is satisfied that by exploiting this fashion or exploiting this knowledge, that particular person will be benefited or that community will be benefited, then can grant. And if without this continuous process, if anybody has copied, then of course it will come under the copyright infringement. We have heard a lot of kind of fashion, lot of song, you can say, where the people has to pay a huge amount. I think you all have heard about the song Ghumro Ghumro. This was a traditional song. It was it was the song from the Rajasthan. So folk song was there. It was copied and used in the film industry. And there the composer has to pay a huge amount to that particular person who has invented that particular rural song or folk song, I'll say. So for traditional fashion also, the moment anyone is copied, then the action will be taken under copyright. Plagiarism is something different, which is not actually the proper time to say here. In 2018, we have got a huge term. Even the word itself is a copyrighted word. Sometimes we use it in form of plagiarism, plagiarism, but this is a phonetically four syllables are there. A lot of stories are there. We will discuss it here. Yes.
Okay. Ma'am, next question is from Amit Brother Nag. His question is it a problem to use open source in our project?
This is the question from the 2018 UGC guideline for copying the material. Regarding OER, first of all, for the student, this answer I'm giving for the student, that if you want to exploit any OER, then you must go first of all in search, you type your search material, you type there. The thing will come, a used material. So sometimes we are not able to understand which particular portion should be copied and which should not be. Then it is better, it is easy way to identify. You go to search. There, in search, you will find a work advanced search. You go there, advanced search. In advanced search, you will get different types of write-up in form, in a way of form. Then you go to the just below, you drop down your cursor, you will find free use without license. So free use without license, if you are exploiting that much of information, then it will not come under the copyright violation or plagiarism under the Copyright Act or under the UGC guideline 2018. Now regarding this plagiarized work, there are four level of work designated in 2018. One is if you have copied up to 10%, this is called level one, it is granted. If it is more than 10% and is coming up to 40% copy, then maybe a student, scholar, the person from academics like us, any person, if the work copied is from 10 to 40%, then that project, that particular report, dissertation, thesis, whatever, that we'll have to again submit after acknowledging that particular copied work or to remove the copied work within 1 year of span. If it is more than 40 to 60%, then that year we can't again resubmit our project, our all the, you know, project dissertation report, whatever we are writing for starting from the bachelor degree, from the student level, from class 12 till the PhD and post PhD. We have to file sometime, we have to write reports, projects, everything. So if it is more than 40 to 60%, then that will be resubmitted, but not that year, after the expiry of 1 year. This is the punishment here, I will say. And there should maybe lapse for the student also. And if it is more than 60%, then very sorry to inform that my registration will be canceled. Then the particular faculty member who has put his signature on that report, on that particular project, then the criminal action may be taken against that. So this is the guideline given by UGC in the year 2008.
Okay, ma'am, this is the last question. How can we use picture, diagram, and knowledge from books to make a YouTube video without violating Copyright Act?
It is very easy. When I'm saying that 1 to 40% directly or indirectly you can use from wherever you are taking, why you are not acknowledging it? UGC or any other institutions of the academy, they are allowing you to copy. Copyright is violated when you are not taking permission from the copyright holder. But if I am taking any picture, any YouTube material, any image, then the first thing is I will take where it is coming. It comes in public domain, which is copyright free material, through that advanced search and all these process. But the other way is you take help in your research. This is called fair use. That I'll take pictures, I'll take all the documents, everything, but I have to acknowledge that I am taking. Research work, we are carrying on for two purposes. One, I'm taking help from other books and I'm creating my thought. And sometime I'm going to the field, I'm taking first-hand experience and making my project. So in both ways, I can utilize any material, any photo, any image, but in that case, in footnote or end note or in the reference, I have to acknowledge that, yes, I have copied. And for educational purpose, we know that copyright infringement is very limited in it. So for educational purposes, we can exploit any resources by acknowledging the source from where. Even you will see in my first page of slide, first slide, I have taken that raw, that is an image from government's site. And there I have written the source from where, though it is free portal, but I have written their source. So of course, for the variety of knowledges, I have to acknowledge it. Don't create misrepresentation or fraud towards the educational system that this is the creation of my own. This is only this much the educational institutions are expecting from.
Thank you, ma'am. Hope all the participants had get their answer. Thank you very much, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you very much, all the organizers. Thank you.
Next session will be handled by the host.
Hello. Hello. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. And thank you, Neelam. Now we are at the end of the session. Now I would like to request our IQAC coordinator, Dr. Amol sir, please come on the online platform and for vote of thanks. Hello. Hello. Hello.
Hello, Birudha.
Shyamal sir, yes sir. Hello. You can continue, sir.
Okay. Good afternoon to all viewers. It is my privilege and honor to be the one making the vote of thanks in such a distinguished and intellectually stimulating virtual gathering. On behalf of Asansol Girls College, I express my deep sense of gratitude to honorable resource persons, Dr. Shati Sinha, former HOD of Law Department KNU, who took out her valuable time from her busy schedule and blessed us with a lecture about intellectual property right concept and need, which is very helpful and aware to students, this scholar, and all others about patent, copyright, design, etc. I take this opportunity to thank our Vice Principal, Dr. Sandeep Kumar Ghatak, for lending all the support to us. I am extremely thankful to my colleagues from the neighboring colleges who took out time from their busy schedule to attend the webinar. I also very grateful to all the teaching staff, conveners, organizing committee members of my college who have worked hard for organizing this webinar. Lastly, I would like to thank and congratulate more than 700 registered participants for their active participation, without whom it would not have been possible to arrange the webinar. Again, thank you all.
Thank you, sir. Participants are requested to you, please fill up your feedback form. Feedback link already has given to your mail address. Please put your valuable feedback in the feedback form. It will open after the session. Thank you. Thank you all.
Shall we end the session?
Yes, end the session.
That's why I'm asking you.